All right, in this video, we are going to weld on some 1.5-inch flanges so that down the road we can put a handrail on top of the shipping container if we want to, or solar panel mounting brackets. We are also going to weld on a 2-inch stud that is threaded so that we can put gutters on the top of the shipping container. And then we are also going to weld an piece of angle iron right down the center on the top outside of the shipping container to strengthen the roof so that we can walk up there and that there's no flexing in the roof while you're up there working on solar panels or whatever you want to do. So that's what hopefully this whole video is going to encapsulate, and we'll get it put together here and see how it goes. It has rained. Every time I turn around, I'm getting rained out, or it's wet and rainy and I can't get up outside with the welder. All right, when I pick the ladder up here, you can see down the edge of the top of the shipping container where I've welded on a series of 2-inch threaded studs. They're every 2 feet. And this upcoming footage here is where the stud for the gutter meets up with one of the 1.5-inch flanges. So you'll see both of those installed coming up here. The stud is where the gutter screws in, and the 1.5-inch flange is where the handrail will screw in. So that's what this process coming right here up is, a combination of the two of those. And I have discovered that I can make a lot better weld if I put on a pair of magnifying glasses. The welds turn out so much better. You can actually buy a welding helmet that has a magnifying lens in it, and it's probably worth the effort. I didn't have one, so I just used the glasses, but it is definitely makes a big difference. And my tribulations with the sun causing glare on the inside of my welding helmet It got so frustrating, I put like a whole roll of duct tape on the back of that helmet to keep the sun out, and it worked very well, and I'm glad I did it, even though it's kind of ghetto. Right here I'm cleaning the spatter out of the end of my nozzle from welding up uphill. They make some stuff called nozzle grease. Works real well. I made this little spacer out of the material where I cut the windows out. It's just part of the shipping container that was left over that I repurposed. Here's a good example of the roof flexing before the angle iron was welded to the top center of it.
recommend 3 drills for this project. You need a drill with a wire wheel on it, a drill with your grinding wheel on it, and a drill with your cutoff wheel on it. You can get cheap drills out there. Definitely saves a lot of trouble and headache just switching the electric cord instead of switching the device on one drill. I started out with one drill and was switching that. It didn't take long for me to go buy 2 more drills. And so there is a gutter stud and an inch and a half flange welded on and ready for paint. And here we are taking the welding stuff down off the roof with the old John Deere. I believe this is a 1983. It's somewhere between a 79 and an 83, but she's a good one. Okay, so it's video of me putting the welding equipment on top. Here, these tire tracks are where I used the tractor to move the spiral staircase closer to its final location and out of the way so I could get up on top of the roof. This will give a better representation of how the roof flexes. So that's not the angle iron moving, that is me bouncing up and down on the roof, and it is flexing up and down. The angle iron is not moving, although in this video it looks like that's what's happening. So here is how bouncy it is without the welding. And up here, starting here, where it's welded, wash the welder. And as I get up here, I have it welded. And hopefully I'm not yelling because I got my earplugs in. There's a good example. So we got to weld from here to there. I'll show you what it's like after. Here's how I'm supporting the roof. You can see right here,
where I've been welding from on top. And here it is after welding. See the welder. I don't know how well this can show. It was certainly worth the effort.
So the welding worked very well. Firmed the roof up exactly like I was hoping for. Very pleased with that project right there. My poor old tractor here, I have not had it long. It was sitting in a hay field with flat tire and water in the fuel. No flap on top of the exhaust right there, which is what that boot is for. I actually put it over top of the pipe. But my tractor here will get a restoration after this project is done, probably in about a year or so. But it runs very well and starts well. Everything seems to function well on it. So we'll do a Rust-Oleum restoration on that here in the future. So that wraps up welding the angle iron and the brackets on the roof. The project went really well. It was very hot. This took about a week to do all this because it was a lot of measuring and welding, but it's all very repetitive. There will be a video down the road here after the spray foam is on and of me putting the guttering on, and then there will be one of the handrail. But the guttering video will come up after spray foam. And glad to be done with this project. It was hot. I was tired of climbing. And I'm ready to move on to painting and spray foam, which is coming up shortly. Here's some footage of the deer playing after one of the rainstorms. Have a good afternoon.